First mover advantage in a market is a myth. Everybody thinks that if you have to be successful, you have to be the first in the market. Today, I'm going to prove them wrong and I'm going to tell you why it is so. Welcome to TopEvt, the best place for you to grow your business and improve your life to become the top achiever that you want to be. This is me, Jamie. I'll ask you a question. Which is the first tablet computer that was created? Most of you, you will have the iPad in your mind. The first thing that came into your mind is iPad. If you are a techie, you might remember something else, or you might say that, okay, the first tablet computer is not the iPad. But that's how Apple has dominated that space. In 98, there was Windows XP tablet. It was the first, one of the first tablets. And even before that, I think Toshiba created something similar. That was a concept, but this was mass market available. It was really expensive. It worked on Windows XP, and obvious reasons, it was way ahead of its time, so it didn't catch the market. Few years later, Apple comes and refines the same idea and gives you the iPad, and that's what you remember right now. You think that is the first tablet computer, or that is the first good tablet computer. They dominated that space. Even though Microsoft and some other players were already in that space, they had the first mover advantage. They couldn't leverage it. This is what happens when you dominate a space. When you have dominated a space, your product becomes synonymous with that space. So a good example of this would be Xerox. At a time when you wanted to create a copy, you wouldn't say copy it, Xerox it. How is that possible? They created their brand so strong, dominated the space so strong that all copy machines were known as Xerox machines. Even now, most of the boards say Xerox. They don't say photocopy. Why is that so? Because they have dominated that space. IBM did that once. Most of the computers were known as IBMs. I'm talking about when the computer was new, IBM was synonymous with that space. Later on, they lost that advantage. So what am I trying to say? Do you wait to get into a market? No, I'm not saying that if you have an innovation, if you have a new innovation, get into the market as soon as you can. But if there is someone who is already in the market, who has pioneered the product, doesn't mean that they are going to succeed. It doesn't license a success. And the second thing is, if you are entering a market and it is a revolutionary product, it doesn't license a success. In fact, history has shown that if you are the first in a market for a specific product, the odds are against you, because you have to create that market. So there is a lot of hard work that you will have to do to make that market a viability and people to know the benefits and the problems and everything about your product. To get the people to know the product, that itself is going to take a lot of work. So first mover advantage is a myth, and don't let that hold you back. Time and time, studies have shown that first mover advantage doesn't work. What do you have to take away from this? It's very simple. Don't worry about who is first in the market. As I tell you always, you have to worry about dominating the market. If you can do what Xerox had done one time, that is, if you can dominate a space so much that your product is synonymous with the space, that is, talk about photocopiers, automatically Xerox comes in. Similarly, if you can get your product, or you can become the space, dominate the space so much that there is no other competition named when that space is named. If you can do that, that is a dream place to be. That is an advantage beyond anything you can ever buy. Of course, that is going to take a lot of work, a lot of hard work. But if you can pull that off, that should be your goal. I would suggest keep that as your goal. Work towards it, because that is important. So forget about first movers and think about dominating your space. That is the video for today. If you have any comments or suggestions or questions, leave them in the comments below. If you want to talk to me directly, WhatsApp on the number in the description and my assistants will set up a phone meeting with you. And 30 minutes is going to cost you 1000 rupees. Like, share, subscribe. This has been Jamie for TopEvt. I'll see you in the next video.